Yeah, and I just tend to get bored. And even when I was painting, I'd get bored with different styles. You know, I might do like 30 of one one series. And I'd be like, okay, I've done enough. I'm tired of this. So then I'd find a new fabric or a new material to work on.
Mm-hmm.
And I would just always find new ways of doing my work. And then when I finally had time to concentrate on my work full time, I said, let me go back to these images that I used to create when I was younger and recreate my organic shapes. They are a cast of characters, and they're emotional, they're challenging, they're happy. They're just all the different issues that we go through as human beings. We go through different emotions every day, every month, every year. And while it could be the same image that's repeated in a different color, different format, different materials, I think it's a way in which we all are changing. And we're going through different emotions, yet we are the same person. I'd like everyone to know that all of the art that you see does not happen as a one-person job. I could look at probably every single piece right here and tell you that I had a partner in producing every piece. Yes, I was a creator of making this work, but, you know, I worked with my family's factory in Mexico to create my charms. You know, I worked with Del Mar College, Amara Garza, to learn how to make the process of casting my work. I worked with Austin to the Black Metal Press to make my monotype prints. I worked with a seamstress to actually work on my fur. And I also work with a carpenter who helps me with my resin finish pieces. Working together with other people and having a goal in your mind is just another way in which you can express yourself in various different ways.